Maybe I have to I don't know, video it. I've already spilled the paint of water on it and erected, and so it's kind of an odd time, because I'm pretty sure it's finished, it's over, and I don't want to touch it anymore, and the durations of all of the little tiny brush strokes, what is it here? Yeah, the little tiny little brush strokes here are getting nerve-wracking. I'm starting to get nervous. And so I reached the nervous stage, and so I'm like, well, that's it, it's over. I can't do it any longer. So now I'm like, well, maybe I should have shaded him. Where's in my potato hedgehog here? I should have shaded him more, because there's quite abrupt. And so now I'll start to criticize. You know, he's quite abrupt there as a potato on the bird, and yeah. So I don't know. I'll try to bring it in closer, because it is a cool technique. The tempera is quite amazing. It layers on, and so it fattens extra, and so this was kind of interesting. However, it's very tedious and choric, and I'm not really sure I am going for this effect always, because it does take quite a persistence in the shapes. And each one has its own little, you know, you have to stay in its shape. And so by forcing the shape to happen, the shape to occur, I found out all kinds of problems that I should have first, number one, sketched it. Like the painter teacher said that I'm supposed to sketch it first. And I should have done that. And because I ended up having to re-edit, where is it, this beautiful flower here. Was a wing before. I had to re-edit because I couldn't figure out how he was flying, and so many major changes have occurred there. So yeah, this type of thing goes on. And so yeah, sketch it first if you're gonna do like the symbolic with the I guess it's a symbolic any kind of shape that is an actual form that is known, that is a knowledge and has an acquaintance with a definition, like yes, that's a hedgehog, or yes, that's a little bird, and yes, that's a flower, you know, anything like that. I guess so, sketch it first. I guess that will be helpful if that's your deal, to be more exact on it. But yeah, I'll try to bring it closer, so calm down. on the whatever. So yeah, there they are. And he was, this little hedgehog there was the worst problem, because I had him climbing on the bird, and I couldn't get his movement factor right, and I made his legs too fat, so I'm not sure what to do there. I just have to leave him. And I lost the perspective of his legs. I can't figure out the forward, the backward, and right on it, so forget it. I know, this is quite a funny one. I guess the hedgehog in the middle looks like there was the chic guy. He looks like him, and I'm not really sure how I got him in there. It is funny. The one where he was the unity guy, yeah. I think that was, no, Unified Theory, that was the video. I watched that so many times, I think it blew my head out of the water. And so anyway, what was this other one? Oh yeah, so there's a gray bird there, and there's another bird, and then, oh my gosh, no, they're not free, are they? They're not free birds. I don't think so, no, I think they're in quite a state of troubles, and that's the way it goes. And so where is it? And yeah, and I don't know, it's kind of funky, huh? Because now I have this almost practical dead bird at the top. Is he dead or alive? We have to query, and so you have to get really close into the eyeball to see, and that's the way it goes. He's alive, he's just getting flocked around there, tossed around, rather, with a little few dedications of the momentum here. So it's a funny, it's a kind of a funny piece, I guess so. and I'll try to snapshot a photo and not ruin it. But yeah, I was talking about this. That's the quantum, and I wasn't talking of it. But yes, I was talking of it. It's kind of a clingerant on the mind, isn't it? I can't get rid of the quantum thing. And I was thinking of those bubbles. Remember, a long time ago, they used to have those bubbles at the end of the vlog show. There would be the little bubbles, and it was almost like a little hint. It's like there's already a hint there given that we are in the quantum bubble time. You know what I mean? So here I am on my little quantum bubble show. Yeah. And oh my gosh, showing all of these goodies. And I've been knitting my sweater all kinds of ways, adding extra goods to it. So it's really stronger. Yeah, they're kind of fun. It's not really knitting, it's more like that thing there, too. But yeah, I don't know. I'm not a quantum knowledger of everything, but through the eyes, also, I don't know, I would take it, they keep saying the two-slit experiment, I would go through the eyes also and try to work that as two slits. The quantum entering into your mind, as the light tunnel here from the camera is coming in, zong zong zong, we're receiving that tunnel of light. It's that drastic tunnel of light that is getting that split experience, you know. So it's coming in like zong, and then splitting in through our mind. So we can take it that way also. The tunnel of a person's eyes to your eyes. The same experience, the same split experience going on in our mind. And so when we think about the expansionism of our brain and where it is going here, where it is going there, and you're like, no, expansion is not going that way. I do not want expansion to go this way. And you try to curtail it back, and it's like, no, is it being dragged over into this other place, like you're filled with a whole bunch of bubbles in your head, you know? And so when you're filled with all these bubbles in your head, well, then it's almost like chaos, and there's no way you're ever gonna be able to have it figured out. But yeah, I just want to stay with that thought right now. It's just going into the eye contact, going into the brain, and then having its own. Quantum effects right there from that energy from the that state, and eventually I imagine will the computer camera there be sending? It could be sending, huh? Yeah.